here at the ballpark. And the batter will be the shortstop, Xander Bogaerts.
The shortstop.
Bogaerts, who wears that number two on his back for his idol, Derek Jeter. The pitch. Swing and a miss. 0-1. And that is cut on and missed. That is strike two. Glass now, ready and deals. And takes low for ball one. That one the other way. Arroyo. The throw to first. Bogaerts retired. Here's Jordan Alvarez. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on base and slugging too. Swing and a miss. That's strike one.
Early in the count, you have to be real careful because of that power, but then if this hitter gets a strike or two on him, he's still very comfortable. Because he has the ability to get the barrel to the baseball, he's a threat deep into the count as well.
Not close with that one. Now one and two. Got him. That's out number two. Here is Aaron Judge. First pitch doesn't find the zone. The pit behind with that swing. It's strike one.
Boom. That's cheddar, baby.
Here's a 1-1. And that's downstairs and outside. Started after it. Tried to hold up. Now a look to first. No swing. And there's ball four.
Boog, if I were him, I'd be nibbling around the plate as well. I mean, this guy is just capable of hitting pitches outside of the zone and driving them a long way.
The batter now, Jorge Polanco. Swings through that one. 0-1. A little out front there as he swings through it. And he asks for time before the 0-2 pitch. Righty delivers. Going to count 1-2.
1-2.
And now 2-2.
He wanted that fastball high and tight, looking for a strikeout. Just didn't locate it very well.
Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Judge off of first with two away. Right through there, got him. Down on strikes, and he knew it. Set for the start of the inning. And here's the first baseman, Freddie Freeman. And a pitch. And there's a rocket into the outfield. And the leadoff man aboard. Around first and hustling for second. The throw in. Not going to get him. He's in there. Here's the veteran outfielder, Michael A. Taylor. And that's in there for strike one. High fly ball down the left field line. Alvarez hauls it in, and there's one away.
Here's Reese McGuire. He's someone that really beats up on right-handed pitching. The lefties, however, give him a little bit more trouble. First offering, and it just misses. When Cole's brother-in-law, Brandon Crawford, took him deep, Cole signed a pair of spikes for Brandon Crawford. One that said, adios, pelota, and the other one that said, out of here.
Yeah, calls by the great John Miller and Dewayne Kuiper of the San Francisco Giants.
Left-hand hitter waits. Strike two.
Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit, slightly up, slightly in.
Kicks and fires. And now it's 3-2. Runner at second here, one gone. Started after it. Appeal to third. Got him. Rusty Valentine rings him up. Here's Christian Arroyo. Swing and a pop up. Pasquantino makes the grab, and that will end the inning. Back here in New York, here's the center fielder, Chaz McCormick.
The center fielder.
And a pitch. And there's the strike.
It normally does damage on that pitch in that location. Just a swing and a miss there. I don't think you want to throw it again, though.
Comes up empty on the swing. 0-2 now. Righty to the plate. Pitch misses. That's there. Now 1-2. Off the outside edge. And now the count is 2-2. Two and two. Swings and misses. Gassed it right by him. So up next, Vinny Pasquantino. And first offering is fouled off. One down, base is empty.
1-1.
Nothing here in the bottom of the second. On the ground. And it goes just foul. And now before the 1-2, time is called at home plate. And a pitch. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count. And the right-hander deals. That misses. The count now 2-2.
Well, this is a guy that can be frustrating for pitchers because he fouls off so many pitches and grinds out the at-bat. I'm sure there's some times where a pitcher would rather just give up a first-pitch single than have to waste 6 or 7 pitches on one hitter.
The next offering misses. And that's ball three. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout.
That is seven.
Now it's Evan Longoria's turn.
Evan Longoria.
In there for strike one. And a big swing and a miss.
He finds himself in a tough situation early. Just got to try to simplify it. Take a knock the other way if you can.
Stays alive. The 0-2. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Longoria retired. And that will end the inning. Well, here we go. Top of the third, scoreless game. And now it's Ahmed Rosario. Cole back to work. And that's outside. Out towards right center field. And it drops in, but a good job to keep it in front.
Now back. Alex.
So the lineup flips Verdugo. Over. Here's Alex Verdugo. That one is absolutely belted. Back there. Reaches over the fence and steals a homer.
Well, that would have been huge if it would have snuck over the glove to take the lead, but great athleticism at the wall, goes up and brings back a homer.
Here's Mookie Betts. He's got the power, but great contact skills. One of the best contact hitters in the game. And first offering is fouled off. Chris, you look at Gerrit Cole, and he changed in terms of his profile. He threw a lot of sinkers when he was with the Pirates. When he went to Houston, everything changed. More four-seamers and more reliance on the breaking ball. Stevenson hauls it in, two away.
Boy, that was a hanging breaking ball right there. I think he tried to do a little bit too much. Sometimes those eyes can get really big. I think his swing broke down as well, and that's what caused him to pop it up.
Devers stands in now and watches strike one.
Yeah, you credit the analytics and just the great system that the Astros have notoriously had in terms of helping pitchers.
Got him looking for the strikeout. Couldn't pull the trigger on a fastball at the knees. Back at Yankee Stadium, here's Nolan Gorman.
The second baseman.
The pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike one.
Well, you got to find a way to catch up to that pitch. Perhaps shorten the swing, eliminate the stride. That one came in hot, but right down the middle, you're saying to yourself, how did I miss that pitch? Got to make a quick adjustment.
Next offering is fouled back. The 0-2. Ground ball to the right side. The flip to the pitcher covering. Leadoff hitter gone in the third. And now the catcher comes up to him. Tyler Stevenson. He swings and misses at the first pitch. 0-1. Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike two.
Just not able to catch up to that velocity.
0-2 now. And a pop up. Right side. Foul territory. Freeman hauls it in for the out. Two up, two down. And here is Xander Bogaerts. He's 0-1. Bogaerts measures 6 feet 2 inches, 30 years old now, and he was born in Aruba. And that's a base hit into left field, and that keeps the inning going.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Solid swing from start to end, on time with everything, really good balance, nice extension, and he met it out front for the line drive knock.
Now it's Yordan Alvarez. Check swing, went around. Slider right there.
He's got time.
Glass now back to work, the 0-1. Swings through that one.
0-2.
Good eye right there. got him swinging. Couldn't catch up to the heater. On to the fourth. Now it's the DH, J.D. Martinez.
J.D. Martinez.
And here comes. Called strike right there.
You know, these Dodgers, to put it bluntly, need to put together more competitive at-bats, and I don't think they've lived up to their own expectations at the plate. I think things are happening a little quicker than this offense would like, and we see it in the numbers. They're hitting into a lot of outs early in the at-bat.
High fly ball out towards left field. This one's got a chance. And out of here. That one felt good. The Dodgers strike first. It's 1-0. Freddie Freeman up to the dish. Doubled his first time up. Line drive, base hit.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Now it's going to be Michael A. Taylor. Judge calls it in, and there's one away. Reese McGuire will hit next. Went down on strikes his first time through.
McGuire.
Strike one.
0-1.
That one to first. Dives and he can't hang on. Christian Arroyo steps to the plate for the Dodgers. 0-1 so far. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one.
Something I'm noticing in this one is that these guys are aggressive early in the count. It makes you wonder if that was talked about in the hitters meeting before this game started.
One out. Runners at first and second.
The healthy cut. Tough pitch at 98, but a really good pass at the ball.
Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. Runner around third on his way to the plate. Safe.
His confidence level is so high. Really nice job of coming through in a big spot. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Rosario in the box here. Lets that one go for a ball. That's outside. And it's 2-0.
Tough spot right here. A couple runners on. Two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
And they're all loaded up.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
Alex Verdugo steps to the plate for the Dodgers. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it.
Hard liner. Oh, great stop. Able to get back into third safely as a run scores on the play.
Well, that was an important at bat in this game, so a great job there stepping up to the challenge. Nice job going the opposite way with it, letting the ball travel and not allowing the barrel to hook around the ball. It's so frustrating when you see a good pitch and your hands roll over. It was on the outside part of the plate, and he approached it perfectly.
And it's fouled away. Check swing, no appeal, and it's 2-1.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
That's in there, 2-2 now. And he asks for time now. Chance to take a breath with the bases loaded. Now all even up. In the air, fairly deep to right field. Judge brings it in. Runner tags from third. Not in time, he's safe.
Well, he's always capable of losing one over the fence. He might have just missed it right there, but a good job driving that run from third.
And a foul ball. Corners are occupied with two down. The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike.
Clearly was sitting on a fastball right there and just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment.
And down on strikes he goes. That ends the frame. Back for more from the Bronx. Here's some real power at the plate. Aaron Judge. And the right-hander back to work. That one finds the zone. 0-1. Singing four homers in 22 games at Old Yankee Stadium. What do you remember?
Well, I remember my rookie year hitting two in one game. And, you know, before that game in the clubhouse, there was a gentleman there who owned a suit company there in downtown Manhattan. And he said to me, "Hey, kid, you hit a home run in the game tonight. Come over to the store tomorrow and I'll give you a free suit."
Swing and a miss, and the count is 2-2.
So I went into the game. I happened to hit two. When I walked into the store the next day, and he looked at me, said, "You're trying to put me out of business, aren't you?" And that was a great, great experience that I had as a rookie playing against the Yankees, playing in New York.
So now here's the DH, Jorge Polanco, struck out looking in his first at bat. And a swing and a miss. So did Super Joe give you two suits?
Super Joe hooked me up with two suits.
Swings and crushes one. Right field, way back, and gone. Jorge Polanco goes deep, and they're on the board. It's 4-1. And next for New York, Chaz McCormick. He was a strikeout victim his first time. Pitch misses inside, and that is ball one. Swing and a miss, and the count 1-2. Now he steps out as time is granted. Swing and a miss, and he got him. Picks up strikeout number 7. Vinny Pasquantino stepping in now for the Yankees. Struck out swinging his first time. And he swings and misses at the initial offering.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Out to short. Throw on to Freeman. That is the inning. Ready now for the fifth inning. And Martinez. The wind of the pitch. Slowly on the ground to short. Bogarts. Now the throw to first on the run. And the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth. Here comes Freddie Freeman up to hit.
Good swing out of him last time. Ripped a liner in the center.
In there at the knees. And that's strike one.
For you growing up in New York City, I mean, you're a big sports fan. Tell me about your experience with the Yankees growing up.
I really went to Shea Stadium more than I did to Yankee Stadium. I grew up a Phillies fan. There was one game, though, that I went to as a kid. I sat in the upper deck. It was the game that Bo Jackson hit three homers in his first three plate appearances and then hurt a shoulder diving for Deion Sanders inside the park home run. That's probably the most memorable game that I ever attended as a fan at Old Yankee Stadium.
He's controlling things out there on the mound, not messing around at all. He's been in attack mode since the very start.
That one fouled off. The 0-1. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two. Time asked for at the plate. Maybe an attempt to break up the rhythm that he's got going on the mound right now. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. Pulled the string on the changeup. We head to the bottom of the fifth. And stepping in for the Yankees, Evan Longoria.
Evan Longoria.
The pitch. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. That's what the fans came to see, and they slice into the lead. It's 4-2. Standing in is the power-hitting second baseman, Nolan Gorman.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
The 0-1. Swing and a miss, 98 on the gun. Got him swinging for the strikeout. The high heat, too much on that one. So digging in, Tyler Stevenson. He popped out his first time. Out there to center. And there are two down. Now here's Xander Bogaerts now. One for two. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Verdugo ranging after it. Makes the play, and it's out number three. Back at Yankee Stadium, all set for the top of the sixth. Here's the catcher, Reese McGuire. Cole back to work. In the air out to center. McCormick on the run. Makes the grab, one away.
He's been going after these guys consistently, and as a result, he's been able to keep his pitch count low, throwing the ball very well right now.
Arroyo, the next to hit, takes outside. That one misses. Two balls, no strikes. The wind of the pitch. On the ground to short, Bogaerts handles the chance. Throws across the diamond. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth. Two outs, base is empty. Now, Ahmed Rosario. Fought off foul. Rosario checks his swing. Now an appeal to first. He did not go around. Ball to strike. The pitch. In the air out towards right center. Drops for a hit. He couldn't run it down. Throws to second, and that's a double.
Anytime you can drive a ball into the gap the other way, it feels so good. And that's when you know you're right where you need to be at the plate. And it's even better when it gets you extra bases. Love looking in at your dugout and seeing the guys fired up.
Back to the top of the Dodgers order. Alex Verdugo steps to the plate for the Dodgers. Dave Roberts turning to his bench for a new bat. Sam Haggerty looking for a two-out hit with a runner in scoring position. First offering misses badly for ball one. Ground ball up the middle. gets it to first, and that is that. Back now in the Bronx, and the batter now, Yordan Alvarez. The right-hander back to work. Check out these numbers. In 2019, he was the American League Rookie of the Year and established a major league record for OPS by a rookie in a single season. 1067 was his on-base plus slugging. Left-hand batter waits. There's the strike.
In that 2019 season, became the first Astro to hit a homer into the third deck at Minute Maid Park. That's an absolute blast.
Swings through that one for strike two. Time called. The 2-2 will have to wait just a second. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. It's Aaron Judge now. A strikeout and a walk. Swings through that one. 0-1. Got the bat going too soon at strike two. Time asked for at the plate, and he gets it. Here comes an 0-2 to Judge. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. That's his second strikeout. And now the DH, Jorge Polanco. He's already homered here in this one. Now time called. Pitching coach coming out for a meeting as two relievers continue to throw in the bullpen. And first offering is fouled off. Kicks and deals. Late with the swing there.
Oh, he's got to be pretty proud of this outing so far. Sometimes guys cower coming into a ballpark like this, but he has attacked hitters. Pitching on the road like this is very impressive. This has been a treat to watch.
Check swing, now an appeal to third. And he held back, according to Rusty Valentine. Hand up as he asks for time at the plate. In the air, center field. Taylor settles under it and makes the catch. And that'll do it. Top of inning number seven, and now the right fielder, Mookie Betts. Here comes a pitch. Strike one. Minter, he's made a name for himself as a very effective reliever, but not really what you expect from a bullpen arm these days because he's not out there racking up Ks. That's in there. That's strike two.
I think it's the deception and his ability to change arm angles and slots and give hitters different looks within one at bat. They're never able to get comfortable. When you only see him once, a lot of times he has success.
Here's a 1-2. That one ripped right center field. That's back. And that is gone. So he goes the opposite way with that one. And they tack on to their lead. It's 5-2. And it's Rafael Devers in the box. First pitch just misses. Got to be clever, too, when you don't have that lights out stuff, right?
Absolutely. You got to know what you're able to do. Instead of focusing on what that hitter's strength is, stay with your strength and trust that you'll come out on top.
Check swing, but he went too far. And a count 1-2. The punch out there, and that's the first out. And here is J.D. Martinez. He's already homered in this game. At the belt and fires. Good eye right there. So now 1-2.
1-2 to count.
The pitch. And a ball evens the count.
It's a good take.
Stop.
Time called. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. He makes the catch, and there's two down. And now it's going to be Freddie Freeman. And first offering is fouled off. Two outs. And he takes a strike.
Well, this guy's so comfortable hitting with two strikes. Even a good pitch early in the at-bat. If he's not ready to pull the trigger, he's not worried if he gets to an 0-2 count.
Ripped on a line. And makes the grab. And that is that. And welcome back. Bottom of the inning. And stepping in for the Yankees, Chaz McCormick. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Joe Barlow. The Yankees looking to rally. The pitch. And ball one.
No,
talk about the right guy at the right spot. They really need a rally, and this guy is someone you can believe in to find a way to get on base.
Swings and lines a base hit into left field. Off to a good start with a leadoff dive.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there.
Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
And now here is Vinny Pasquantino. And the first offering is not close.
If you're going to get something going, this is the time to do it. You get the leadoff man on. Everybody's got to look over the shoulder and say, I'm just going to keep the line moving. Don't try to do too much.
Right-handed reliever. That one pushed foul out of play off to the left. The 1-1. And that one wrapped foul. Nobody out. Runner at first. Fouls it off. Still 1-2.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
Barlow checks on first. McCormick back in on a dive. One and two now. Spoils a two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. McCormick on at first. Nobody out. Fights that one away. Still 1-2. The pitch. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count. Chance to collect himself now as he asks for time. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Fouls that off to the left, and we'll do it again. And that's just foul. Runner at first with no outs here. Next offering is fouled back. One and two here. Swung on, belted. That one's carrying. And it is gone. This place is absolutely loving it. And they cut into the lead. It's 5-4. Evan Longoria getting ready to hit. Now time is called here. Pitching coach on his way out to the mound. It's 0-1.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit, just not able to square it up.
Righty delivers. That one missing inside.
Man, oh man, I don't know how you take that pitch. That's as close as it gets.
Swings and misses, struck him out. Couldn't catch up to the heater. So up next, Nolan Gorman.
Three-pitch strikeout last time up. Got to put up more of a fight in this one.
Caleb Ferguson gets the ball now. He's into the game with the bases empty. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one. Still only one out here in the inning. Pitch misses, and it's 1-1.
1-1.
Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Devers settles underneath it. That's out number two.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
And right back to the mound. On to first, inning over. And now the center fielder, Michael A. Taylor.
Number 56.
And he deals. That's down and in.
You know, these Dodgers, simply put, are producing a lot of quality swings. We've heard lots of loud noise coming from their bats in this one, haven't we? I mean, they've logged six hits at 90-plus exit velocity, and that doesn't happen by accident.
Started after it. Appeal to first. And he went around. Ruled a swing. And a pitch. Battling here as he fouls it away. 1-2 now. Got him. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. And now, Reese McGuire. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Making a move at first on a pinch run for the Dodgers. Edmundo Sosa.
Edmundo Sosa.
And here is Christian Arroyo. That misses the zone, and that's ball one. Swing and a ball popped up and it drops in. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it second with one gone.
Now
Ahmed Rosario steps to the plate for the Dodgers.
Really good piece of hitting last time going to the opposite field.
Ball one, no strikes. Sosa at second, Arroyo at first, one gone. That misses 2-0.
Really been able to slow down the game tonight with his at-bats, and the biggest one he's had so far. He doesn't look anxious at all.
2-1.
Swing and a miss. Now 2-1. Just missed.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Oh, this is their chance to break it open. If they don't end up winning this ball game, they're going to look back at this opportunity right here and have some regret. In the infield at the corners, don't be surprised to see them come home first and prevent that run from scoring.
Line drive and a base hit. There comes the throw. Runner from second scores as they add on. Now a three-run game, 7-4.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Nice line drive to the pole side right there, but he didn't spin off of it. That's the key. You still have to extend through the baseball in order to hit a line drive like that.
Betts in the box now. No balls and a strike. The 0-1.
That's the ball. 1-1.
And there's a ball.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the...
Runners on the move. Swing and a miss. And they put the tag on him for the out. No throw, safe at second. And one in scoring position. Three, two now. And down on strikes, and that's the third out. back in New York, ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's Xander Bogaerts. And the pitch. That one drifts inside. Got him to chase one above the zone there.
Yeah, I don't think anyone's got good numbers swinging at pitches in that location.
Timeout asked for and given at the plate now. Got him swinging.
The bat.
Now the number two hitter, Yordan Alvarez.
Got to keep things airtight defensively right here. On your toes, ready to make a play. If you can get this to the ninth with a three-run lead, it should be a W.
That one ripped. Diving, gets down, could be extra bases. They're still chasing it as he rounds second. In there safely.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle.
Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle, allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws.
So the Dodgers have a new arm on the mound, Evan Phillips.
We all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
Yeah, Judge spoils that one. And the righty deals. Not even close there. And it's a ball and a strike. And that's in for a strike. And now it's 1-2. Ripped towards third. Devers throws out to first. Judge out on the play. Next is the designated hitter, Jorge Polanco. 1-3. High fly ball lifted in the air right field. Betts brings it in for the third out. All set to start the ninth in this one. And here is Devers.
Rafael Devers. Your attention, please. Now, number 46.
The pitch. And that one is inside. Alvarado, the lefty who lights up the radar gun. 27 years old, and he was born in Venezuela. There's a strike. The 1-1. That one hit to right. Judge makes the catch, and there's one gone. JD Martinez stands in. Bounce to the left side. In plenty of time to first. And Martinez is out.
Hey, man, four pitches, two outs. That is an excellent pace.
Freeman, the next to hit, takes ball one. Out towards right center. That's well struck. Gone! Ready, Freeman bops one out of here. And they add a run. It's 8-4.
Anytime you have a pitch down the middle of the plate, the percentages go up for the hitter to do damage, even if it's a pretty good sinker like that one. Nice piece of hitting there at the plate.
So digging in, Michael A. Taylor. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And delivers outside.
Well, he gave up the home run earlier in this inning, not pitching as aggressively here.
2-0 to Cal. Here it comes. Swings and misses at the pitch off the plate. And he grounds one to the right side. Gorman tosses to first. Out number three. Here at New Yankee Stadium in the Bronx, bottom of the ninth, here's the center fielder, Chaz McCormick. Cut on and missed, 96 of that fastball. Oh and two as he waves at that one. And now one and two.
0-2 pitch that far out of the zone gives the hitter a little confidence that maybe he can climb back into this at bat.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. Vinny Pasquantino stepping in now for the Yankees.
Amazing at bat last time up, saw a bunch of pitches and ended up hitting one over the fence.
Time called as the pitching coach makes a visit to the mound. One reliever still getting loose out the pen. New pitcher for the Dodgers, Drew Pomeranz.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
And takes low for ball one. And fouled off.
Looked like you got a little excited on that fastball. Got to think to yourself, you want to stay up the middle. That way, if you're a little bit early, you hit it out of the ballpark. If you're a little late, opposite field knock.
And one and two. Got him. And there's two away. Now. Evan Longoria stepping in now for the Yankees. Ball one, no strikes. And that one hammered. Back there. His second home run of the game, and they close the gap. It's 8-5. Base is empty with two away. Now it's the second baseman, Nolan Gorman. That one lifted to left. Haggerty under it. And that is the ball game.
Well, I'd say we got treated to a good one. Gotta love a game when you get 13 runs on the board. A lot of offense, but it doesn't end in a blowout. Tons of really good at-bats to look back on in this one.
And this one ends with the score 8-5. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Shombi saying so long.
To let the mic smoke. Now I slam it when I'm gonna make sure it's broke. When I'm going, no one gets on, cause I won't let nobody press up.
Here now is our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Dodgers, 8 runs on 12 hits. No errors. They left 7 men on base. For the Yankees, 5 runs, 7 hits, 1 error. They left 3 men on base. Time of the ball game. 3 hours and 38 minutes. Our paid attendance here tonight at Yankee Stadium, 47,309. The Yankees thank you for attending and remind you to please get home safely.